My dear share owners, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. It is 2 p.m. and time to start the meeting. I welcome all of you to the 44th Annual General Meeting of the company. This meeting is held through video conferencing because of the prevailing situation. This is in compliance with the circulars issued by the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, Government of India, and the Securities and Exchange Board of India. The company has taken all feasible steps to ensure that the shareholders are provided an opportunity to participate in the annual general meeting and vote. Adequate video conferencing facility and live webcast of the proceedings of this meeting have also been provided. The requisite quorum is present, and therefore, I call the meeting to order. The register of directors and the key managerial personnel and their shareholding and the register of contracts or arrangements in which directors are interested are available. This will remain accessible to the members for inspection electronically if they so desire. I wish to introduce, for the benefit of new members, my colleagues on the board of the company. Shri Y. P. Trivedi, Dr. R. A. Mashelkar, Professor Deepak Jain, Shri Adil Zanulbhai, Shri R. S. Gujral, Dr. Shumit Banerjee, Srimati Arundhati Bhattacharya, Shri K. V. Chaudhary, Srimati Neeta Ambani, Shri Nikhil Meswani, Shri Hital Meswani, Shri P. M. S. Prasad, Shri P. K. Kapil, all the directors of the company are present at this meeting. Shri Alok Agarwal and V. Srikant, CFOs, K. Sethuraman and Savitri Parikh, company secretaries, and the representatives of our statutory auditors and secretarial auditor are also present at this meeting. Ladies and gentlemen, notice dated 27th May 2021 convening this annual general meeting and a copy of the annual report for the financial year ended March 31, 2021 have already been circulated to the members of the company electronically. With your permission, I shall take them as read. The auditor's report on the standalone and the consolidated financial statements and the secretarial audit report of the company for the financial year ended March 31, 2021 do not contain any qualification, reservation, adverse remark or disclaimer. Accordingly, the reports are not required to be read out as provided in the Companies Act 2013. Now, I will begin my formal address to all of you, my dear shareholders. My dear share owners, a very warm welcome to each and every one of you. It gives me great pleasure to greet you all at the 44th Annual General Meeting of Reliance Industries Limited. It is the second year in a row that I miss the intimacy and the warmth of face-to-face interaction with you because of the COVID pandemic. However, the virtual format has enabled several lakhs of our shareholders to participate in this AGM from the safety of their homes. Friends, we are in the midst of a humanitarian crisis. Its scale, severity, and geographical spread are unseen in a century. It has filled the hearts of all Indians with enormous pain and grief. Several of our employees and shareholders have borne the brunt of this pandemic. Within our one large Reliance family, the suffering of any member becomes the suffering of all of us. Today, Nita, I, and my colleagues on the board offer our heartfelt condolences to all those in our Reliance family who have lost their loved ones to this pandemic. I now request that all of us observe a minute of silence in the memory of the departed souls. Om Shanti. Esteemed shareholders, the company's accounts for the year ended 31st March 2021 have already been circulated to you. With your permission, I would like to take them as read. Our business performance and financial success since the last AGM have exceeded our expectations despite the pandemic. But I shall come to that later in my address. What has given me far greater happiness than our business performance is Reliance's humanitarian efforts during these exceedingly difficult times. I feel both proud and humbled to share with you that throughout the COVID crisis, our Reliance family has risen to the occasion with a sense of purpose and national duty. Our entire organization has become energized with the spirit of service. Every single employee has participated directly or indirectly in the fight against COVID and become a goodwill ambassador of Reliance. I'm sure our efforts of the last 1 year would have made our founding chairman, Shri Dhirubhai Ambani, proud, because the one common unifying thread that runs through everything we have ever done at Reliance is the spirit of care and empathy. We care for our employees and their families. We care for our customers, our shareholders, and our partners. We care for the country and the community. We care for the planet and the people. This is what the true Reliance spirit was, is, and will always be. I now invite Isha, Akash, and Nita to tell us about our COVID missions of Reliance and the wonderful work done by all our colleagues.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Isha Ambani.
And I am Akash Ambani.